rotational kinetic energy. Let me see whether you are able to understand. By logic means by analogy. By analogy means by comparison. If I say by comparison, tell me what will be rotational kinetic energy. Then some of you will say, sir, half is half in comparison. V in straight line becomes omega in rotation. That means in circular motion. So mass is called as moment of inertia denoted by I. So my translational kinetic energy will become half I omega square, which will be rotational kinetic energy. So let us check whether we get this answer. Half mass becomes I, V becomes omega in expression for rotational kinetic energy. Heading written, did I have expression for rotational kinetic energy?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What answer should come at the end? Half
I w
omega. Omega square. It is not W, it is omega. Omega. Let us check whether we'll get half I omega square or not. This is one rigid body I'm drawing. You can draw any shape. Rotating about an axis, passing through O with uniform angular velocity omega. Let M1, M2, M3, Mn be the masses of n particles at distance R1, R2, R3 up to Rn from axis of rotation. So when this particle rotates, it will perform circular motion like this. This will also perform circular motion, circular motion, circular motion in anti-clockwise direction. Velocity is along tangent. This is V1. M2 ka velocity is also along tangent V2. M3 is along tangent V3. Mn is along tangent Vn. Just draw this much first. Any shape ka body you can draw. Mark 4 points. Center O, R1, R2, R3, Rn, then circle, tangent, circle, tangent, circle, tangent, circle, tangent. This is V1, V2, V3, Vn.
Done, sir.
Okay, let others also complete. Energy is a scalar quantity or vector quantity? What is energy, scalar or vector?
Scalar, sir.
Scalar. So, पूरा पार्टिकल का एनर्जी ऐड करना है तो वेक्टर सम लो क्या अलजेब्रिक सम लो?
अलजेब्रिक.
वेरी गुड, करेक्ट. नाउ एवरीबॉडी हैज ड्रॉन द डायग्राम, प्लीज टेल.
यस सर.
ओके, एकदम सिंपल डेरिवेशन है, कुछ इतना टेंशन नहीं, खाली थोड़ा सा सेम चीज रिपीट करना है. अभी मैं ऐसा बोलता हूं, कंसीडर a rigid body rotating about an axis passing through O with uniform angular velocity omega. Consider rigid body rotating about an axis passing through with uniform angular velocity omega. Let M1, M2, ... comma Mn be the masses of n particles of rigid body rotating and be M1, M2, Mn be the masses of n particles of rigid body and particles of rigid body at distances of r1, r2, rn from axis of rotation. All particles performs angular velocity, performs rotational motion with same angular velocity. मतलब सब सेम एंगल कवर करने वाले सेम टाइम पे, सो सेम एंगुलर वेलोसिटी, बट डिफरेंट लीनियर वेलोसिटी. अनमोल कैन यू से व्हाई इट इज डिफरेंट लीनियर वेलोसिटीज? आई से सेम एंगुलर बट डिफरेंट लीनियर. ध्रुव नो आइडिया? अमय
सर मे बी डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज
नो. वी का फॉर्मूला क्या है? आर ओमेगा है ना?
यस सर.
ओमेगा सेम है लेकिन हर एक पार्टिकल का आर तो अलग है ना?
यस सर.
देयरफॉर ओमेगा सेम बट डिफरेंट लीनियर वेलोसिटी वर्ड वी आर यूजिंग. नाउ फॉलोड?
यस सर.
ओके टिल दिस वंस अगेन. सी कंसीडर रिजिड बॉडी rotating about an axis passing through O with uniform angular velocity omega. Let m1, m2 up to mn be the masses of n particles of rigid body at distance r1, r2, rn from axis of rotation. All particles performs rotational motion with same angular velocity, that is omega, but different linear velocities because their r are different. Copy till this explanation.
Done, sir.
Okay. पर सबका हो गया इतना लिखे. Consider rigid body rotating about an axis passing through O with uniform angular velocity omega but different linear velocity. Let m1, m2, mn be the masses at distance r1, r2, rn. All particles performs rotational motion with same angular velocity but different linear velocity. Can I clear this now?
Yes.
Okay. Now till end I am explaining you. Let V1 comma V2 up to VN be the linear velocities of N particles. So V1 equals to R1 omega, V2 equals to R1 omega dot dot dot, Vn equals to Rn omega. Let E1 comma E2 up to En be the kinetic energies of N particles. Therefore, E1 equals to half M1 V1 square, which will become half M1 R1 square omega square, because V1 is R1 omega. E2 equals to half M2 V2 square, that is half M2 R2 square omega square. Dot, dot, dot. for nth particle half of mn bn square, which is half of one minute, this pen is not working. So this is equals to half of mn rn square omega square. Therefore, resultant kinetic energy, comma, E will be first particle energy, second particle energy, up to last particle energy. So E equals to half of m1 r1 square omega square, half m2 r2 square omega square, last particle is half mn rn square omega square. I can take half omega square common inside m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square, last wala mn rn square. So E equals to half omega square. This is nothing but summation of miri square. Summation means adding all the terms. Now, what is this miri square called? Is it moment of inertia? This summation of?
Yes, sir.
So my final answer will become half I omega square. Okay. Any doubt anywhere?
No doubt, sir.
Please copy. Thank you. Just read everything from the start. Any doubt, please ask me immediately.
No doubt, sir.
So can I move ahead then?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Expression here have expression for torque.
Sir, screen is not changed.
So I'm just telling us why you want screen to be changed. Derive expression for torque acting. Derive expression for torque acting Derive expression for torque acting on a rigid body. Derive expression for torque acting on a rigid body. Now, if this is one body rotating in anti-clockwise direction, so all particle will rotate in anti-clockwise or only few particle will rotate in anti-clockwise?
Sir, all particles.
All particles, correct. Now, we know that torque in vector form is R bar cross F bar.
Yes, sir.
Vector product of two vector is always perpendicular to the plane containing two vector, given by right hand screw rule.
Yes, sir.
If the sense of rotation is anti-clockwise, where is your thumb directed? Up or down? With right hand, take your curled finger in anti-clockwise. Where is thumb? Where you are sitting?
Upward direction, sir.
Upward, yes. Right hand ko open karo aur apna finger, curled finger ko anti-clockwise karo. Thumb upar dikh raha hai phir?
Haan, sir.
So this is called right hand thumb rule. So every particle ka torque will be upward. So if all the torques are upward, 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 what will be resultant? Just add na. If all vectors are in same direction. What is result? Just add na.
Sir.
अगर दो opposite होते तो subtract. और perpendicular रहता तो Pythagoras theorem.
Yes, sir.
So consider rigid body. सेम डायग्राम ऐसा बनाओ वापस कोई भी शेप का रिजिड बॉडी बना दो रोटेटिंग अबाउट एन एक्सेस पासिंग थ्रू ओ बनाओ ये हियर आई एम टेलिंग एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन अल्फा जस्ट ड्रॉ दिस मच कंसीडर अ रिजिड बॉडी रोटेटिंग अबाउट एन Excess passing through O with uniform angular acceleration alpha. Mark first particle, second particle, third particle, fourth particle. Give the name. M1, M2, M3, M4. So this is R1, R2, R3, MN लिख लो इसको तो ये RN distance पे होगा. Again, because it is moving in circular motion, draw arcs for all the particle, which shows that this is its path of motion. Write A1, A2, A3, they are along tangent to that curve AN. Instead of V1, V2, V3, VN, we are writing A1, A2, A3, AN. Let M1, M2, dot, 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 up to MN be the masses of N particles and R1, R2, up to RN be their distances from axis of rotation. Consider rigid body rotating about an axis passing through O with uniform angular acceleration alpha. Let M1, M2, MN be the masses of N particles, R1, R2 where their distance from axis of rotation. Can I clear now?
Yes, sir, you can clear it now.
All particles, same history we are writing again and again. All particles performs rotational motion with same angular acceleration, same angular acceleration alpha, but different linear acceleration. See, few things it's from circular motion I am writing. So, जिसने late join किया उनको circular motion में हो जाएगा वो. Let A1, A2, An be the linear accelerations. So A1 is equals to R1 alpha and A2 equals to R2 alpha dot 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 An equals to Rn alpha. Let F1, F2 up to Fn be the forces acting on n particles. F1, F2, Fn be the forces acting on n particles. Let, see, this is called as tau 1, T-A-U, tau. Torque is denoted by tau. Let tau 1, tau 2, tau n be torques on n particles respectively. Therefore, tau 1 equals to R1 F1. And F means mass into acceleration. A, we got R1 alpha. So it will become M1 R1 square alpha. Same way, tau 2 is R2 F2, which is R2 M2 A2. That is R2 M2 R2 alpha. That means M2 R2 square alpha. Dot 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 tau n is Rn Fn, that is Rn Mn An. So Rn Mn Rn alpha, which is Mn Rn square. Therefore, as all the torques are in same direction, therefore, resultant torque just copy till this. If completed, then tell. So resultant torque is tau 1 plus tau 2 up to tau n. This is m1 r1 square alpha, m2 r2 square alpha, dot dot dot, last wala is mn rn square alpha. Yes, done.
Yes, sir, done.
Okay. Can I clear first full so that I can take common?
Yes, sir.
Others have done?
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Yes. Take aram se, aram se. Ghai nahi. ये चैप्टर खाली क्या है, बीच बीच में सेम 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 चीज आता है और कुछ नहीं इसमें. दूसरी ऑफ डन, टेक अल्फा कॉमन इनसाइड m1r1 square प्लस m2r2 square डॉट 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 प्लस mn rn square.
Done, sir.
Okay, so this is nothing but summation of m I r I square therefore tor equals to one more line I am writing, but summation of m I r I square is nothing but moment of inertia denoted by I. But summation of mi ri square is called as moment of inertia denoted by I. So torque is I alpha. This is expression for torque acting on rigid body. So we did, what is moment of inertia today? Rotational kinetic energy, torque. This also please take 2 minutes, read everything. Any doubt in any statement, please ask. Yes, everybody has read.
Yes, sir. No doubt.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, it is not difficult, but lengthy, because same. We are repeating for n particle. Right. Derive expression for angular momentum of rigid body. Derive expression for angular momentum of rigid body. So angular momentum, linear momentum, we all know mass into velocity. So angular should come I omega by comparison. Mass becomes I, V becomes omega. Let us check. So just draw one rigid body of any shape first. Rotating with angular velocity omega. This is mass m1 at distance r1. This is velocity v1 for that particle. Same way you can take another particle m2 at distance r2, tangentially velocity v2. Third particle m3, velocity is v3, distance r3. Fourth particle vn at distance rn having mass mn. Yes, diagram done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, consider a rigid body. Consider a rigid body. Rotating about an axis passing through O with uniform angular velocity omega. Let M1, M2 dot dot dot, comma Mn be the masses of n particles of rigid body at distances of R1, R2, up to Rn from axis of rotation. Next paragraph. All particles. This part I can clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. All particles performs rotational motion with same angular velocity, but different linear velocities. Let V1, comma V2, dot dot dot, comma Vn be the velocities of n particles. Therefore, V1 equals to R1 omega, V2 equals to R2 omega, dot, 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 Vn equal to Rn. So today we stop here. Till this we'll do. Complete till this.
Done, sir.
Okay. So this much you please revise and come. इसके बाद खाली दो तीन डेरिवेशन है, मतलब दो लेक्चर में